Kontakt zu Riga. Frage aan de mensen.
Niet zo laat, bro!
Vandaag staan we in Riga en we gaan vragen aan de inwoners van Riga wat zij denken over alcoholtoerisme en alcohol.
Hallo, please tell me your name and where you come from.
Maximilian, from Riga, Madope.
I'm Anna, also from Riga.
Oscar's from Riga.
Richard's from Riga.
And how old are you?
16.
I'm standing here in Riga talking to...
Mari, I'm 23, I'm from Oslo, Norway.
Julie, 24, from Oslo.
My name is Maris, and I'm 24 years old, and I'm from Riga, Latvia.
Do you love alcohol?
Of course I do.
How many times a week do you drink a beer or something else with alcohol?
Two or three days a week in a week.
And what do you prefer?
I prefer beer and whiskey.
Good choice.
Thank you.
Hello, what's your name?
Christa Lorentzen.
And where you come from?
From New York City.
How long are you staying in Riga?
Riga for 2 full days.
And Latvia?
Latvia for 9 full days.
So after Riga, you go to somewhere else, or?
Yes.
What are the plans for this trip?
We started off at Barini. We stayed at a old manor house on a lake. Then here to Riga, and then we're going to the countryside again for the rest of the trip.
And why? Why Latvia? Kiki draugs, jau kai vīnums turis baigā. Vai tu vēl atceries to līdzi paļu? Viļi šauks tāpat veika rastākajā. I'm sitting next to
Levis. I'm 27.
And you're living?
I live in Riga, Latvia.
And I'm Rohit. And I'm 22 years old and I also live in Riga.
Do you guys like alcohol?
Yeah, we do.
Did you ever try a beer or something with alcohol in it?
Yes. Yes, I've tried.
How many times?
I think once.
Once?
well, we wanted to go places that we haven't been before. And doing some research, it sounded like a beautiful country with a lot of open
alcohol.
Spaces. we hadn't done a lot of research on the alcohol aspect, but we've enjoyed some here.
And you drink nothing?
Yeah, I don't drink, but yeah, maybe I can answer some of the things that my friends drink or something like that.
Oh yeah, you can do if you drink. Yeah. You can act like a drunk bastard or something.
So it's like mostly Heineken or something like that, or maybe ciders.
I will stop this interview with you because Heineken is shit. Do you think Latvians are big alcoholics?
Oh, definitely. Yeah. It's just in the culture. Unfortunately,
I would say. We double down on it. We really double down on it. it's a culture, you know. It's fun though.
Yes. Yes.
Comparing with Dutch,
yeah.
Comparing with Russians, same.
Not more than we are.
No, I think we are more.
Yes.
Actually.
I know. We used to like a drinking culture, so.
Yeah.
Yes.
I've read that they like to drink, but we haven't really experienced it yet.
Yeah, I think so. I think Latvians drink like very much, but not as much as Russians though.
And do you know there is alcohol tourism at the border with Estonia?
Yes, I do. But I have heard that it's going out because the Estonians have reduced the tax on the alcohol.
Do you think that's a good thing for Latvia or not?
I think not, because people from Finland is also coming to Latvia just to buy alcohol, and it's good for economical situation over here. So I guess it's not so good, but still, as I heard that their Estonians are reducing the tax, but the tax isn't that as low as we have, and so it will be still higher than in Latvia.
Like I have seen that just like 100 meters after the border, there's a huge alcohol shop in Latvian territory. But there are a couple of them. Like, is that such a big matter?
Maybe you are a bit the same?
I mean, we go to Sweden to buy cheap alcohol, so...
We smuggle from Sweden.
Yes. It's like we drive 1 to 2 hours and then we buy cheap alcohol in Sweden and then we return back to Norway. So, yeah, almost the same.
Yeah. I mean, it's their problem that their country's economic state is at that level that the alcohol is so expensive. So they just, I mean, I'm pretty sure there's a big part of tourists that come to enjoy our country, not because they want to buy alcohol. And yeah, I don't think it doesn't like affect the reputation of our country.
Nothing. Kan jag lugga lite?
Ja.
Yes. Yes.
Okay, so you're leaving tonight.
Yes.
Are you gonna buy some alcohol and take it with you?
Yeah.
Yes.
And what?
What?
Yeah.
I don't know. Maybe that balsam thing. I don't know what it's called, the Riga balsam or something, and vodka.
And tequila.
Yes.
And gin.
Yeah, maybe. Vodka.
I don't know.
Okay. If you were the government for one day, what would you do?
I mean, I feel like since it really is in the culture, it is really difficult to just erase everything. So if the country would really just control it and not completely try to like get rid of it, it wouldn't be much more sufficient and really make more of an impact than just raising the taxes like, what, 50%?
I guess I will remove the rule selling alcohol after 10 p.m. because I think it's not necessary to stop alcohol selling after the midnight, after 10 p.m.
People always find a way to make or buy alcohol, and it's better if you see how it's done legally, that it's bought in a store legally, than if it's made at home, because making at home it is really, really dangerous. You can have poisoning, you can have the explosions, fires. It's much better if it's, we see what is going on. And it's not the way to just block it, you know, kind of sausage likums.
The dry rule.
Dry rule?
Yeah, like just
where you just can't use alcohol. It's wrong. It's better to change the public's opinion on alcohol and drinking as a whole. Like, for example, we have a lot of ads, advertisements about not drinking and driving and like better to sleep it off and better not to drink at all, because it's much, much better to change the public's opinion than to just try to block it.
Because the opinions will continue to stay the same. So people, if they want something, they will find a way to get it. So you have to change the mentality first.
Okay. Thank you for your time.